When it comes to the, I don't know, the term doodling and drawing and freestyling it, they all encapsulate what a doodle is, essentially. It's just getting something out at the moment that it needs to happen. Just having that freestyle ability to be able to whim something for the sake of doing it. You know, I want to draw a house here. I want to do something that looks pretty bright and colorful. I'm able to do that. I have this inherent playfulness that comes out as a result of knowing how to doodle.
I like doodling just because it gives me different ideas, it loosens you up before you get moving forward.
For me, it's just the easiest way for me to get a thought from here so he out. It's easier through my hands than my mouth, I think. I just build upon these scribbles and I see things in them and they come to life.
You can do it anywhere, you can do it anytime. Like you can grab a napkin in a restaurant, you know? So that's the great thing, it's so portable and accessible.
Everybody begins with an idea and ends with like a final product. And to get from that point A to point B, we all kind of go through the same process, right? As far as doodling, I teach thumbnailing. I teach how to take a thumbnail and build it into like a working comp, a final piece. Just showing somebody as I'm speaking to them, it just helps communicate like my ideas.
Just like an energy is created in the room when you're around other people and like everybody's like putting out like their creative heart like onto paper and like talking about where you get your ideas. And for me it's like nice because it makes you like loose, because it makes it less precious.
What else happens when I get into a room of artists? I get to meet them. They got fantastic energy, man. They're all creating all the time. They're into that zone. And the creative energy never stops. I mean, it's constant. I mean, you can feel the vibes.
The original idea for Doodlefest was just three or four artists just doodling for 72 hours straight. It kind of grew from there. There's nothing like just being able to sit and draw with people for a couple hours with nothing else to do. That's like the motivating thing about Doodlefest, is to bring artists together in a non-competitive environment. So we can just have fun and create.
I like what happens to people when they come in here. It's almost a hypnotism. People come in and they don't know anybody else here, and they sit down and just start drawing. And it doesn't matter if they're an artist or not. They get into their drawing and they all just kind of fall silent. It's almost like being in a church.
The thing that I've enjoyed most about Doodlefest is being able to come into a room like this where like you're able to see so many people like enjoy just making stuff. Like the whole reason why you made art in the first place like comes like flashing back, and you're like, oh, there is power in this. Oh, this is fun. Oh, this is good. And so it's just like really refreshing to be like, all right, this is fun. Oh, thank God.
It's not that often that you get us all corralled. It's like herding kittens as far as getting this many artists together. At the same time, it's just a major relief to create with some of my favorite Instagram accounts that I follow. And we do know each other, but we know each other on a digital platform. And this is a physical platform.
It's a communal feeling, and I feel like these days we don't really get a lot of that anymore. A sense of being in a space with people and doing the same thing together and yet in very different ways. I mean, if you look around at the art, that it couldn't be any more different from one drawing to the next.
As last night is concerned, I can recap and say the experience of drawing with others is always an overwhelmingly good feeling. So when it comes to community and getting all these artists together, then you can really see what a beautiful place this is, because we're all about it and we're making it happen.